Like Greece Orthodox.
So although they've been corrupted, deep down in our belief, we have to believe in that. We can find, look, listen, brother. If whatever is in the Quran, it's been mentioned before, and it goes, you have to find correlation. You have to find something. If I have something in common with you, Allah says in the Quran, yeah? I would have made you all the same people. We could have been all one people, but why did we become different tribes? Because, wait, Allah says it in the Quran. Hikmah, exactly, it is hikmah. But Allah says you would not cease to differ between one another. He wants to say, I believe this. He wants to say, I believe this. But Allah has created one path where we can all come together. We have to find the true Islam.
Anyway, you have a nice day.
And we have to want to be guided to the straight path. And we have to ask Allah to keep us on the straight path.
Baba, yes. Only say what I know. I only say what I know.
Baba, yes. I would have done this anyway regardless, but thank you. I appreciate that. So,
now, Allah Akbar.
Anyway, we got taken away from the main point. I was talking about the five books.
He's talking about the hadith and
Ibn Mata. وَلَمْ يَعْرِفْ إِمَامَ زَمَانِهِ مَاتَ مِيتَةَ جَهِلِيَةَ It's not Muslim, not in Sahih. That's what it says in it. It says the Shia says is Sahih or whatever, but it is
wrong. Why are Shias called Shias? Shia means follow group of followers. Why is it? Bro, we follow the Sunnah. We follow the true Sunnah. We follow the Sunnah of the Haqiqi Sunnah. We follow the truth, the truth within.
So whoever died has not known the Imam of the Prophet.
I'm here to learn.
That's
what I'm trying to say. Trust me, you don't want to go there, bro. Because we are the ones that are called followers. There's only one group in the entire existence from the beginning to the end.
What do you know about Sunnis?
Sunnah of who?
The Prophet.
Okay. If you say that and you truly believe that, which you do not because you are smirking and I can see it in you, wait, brother, I just exposed you. Just let me finish. If you haven't learned that in the past 15 minutes you've been standing here, that let me say what I'm saying, then you will agree. Okay. Because I know no one can disagree with you. Now, let me
you said I was smirking.
Baba,
let me do this. Go on.
Hello.
You pretty much most of you don't know your own intentions. Allah knows all of our intentions. There's a way to find out.
Also, you got everyone here in a straight path.
Obviously, what I was trying to talk about has been interrupted, and we're focusing on what your doubts are in what you believe. Yeah? So I can try and help you, to guide you. It's up to you to follow the straight path. It's up to Allah to help you and stay on the path. Now, ask me your question.
Oh man, let him talk.
Alright, do mud'a on the path. That's the correct way, right? Don't be bullying the kid about he's smirking. He can smile if he wants to. You're talking nonsense, bro.
But why are you trying to learn the differences?
It's Sunni, bro.
That's what I'm trying to say. It's better. What we've been taught is the wrong thing. Yeah? What we're generally being taught by everyone around us is wrong.
No, mud'a
is not
this.
Find common grounds for us to come together. Okay. Not find differences where it divides us. I just gave you verses of the Quran.
Brother, is hitting yourself part of the sunnah?
Yes.
Hitting yourself as part of the sunnah?
Yes.
You're not harming yourself.
Why do you ask something three times when I asked you the first time?
Because you're
asking the question the first time. Why would you?
It shows how you're thinking.
Baba, I don't want to know your opinion. Thank you for sharing your opinion.
Religion is facts.
Baba, thank you for sharing your opinion.
Religion is facts.
Thank you for sharing your opinion. Thank you.
The deen is not an opinion. That's why you're wrong.
Yes.
The brother said hitting himself is not allowed.
Let me go back to what I was talking about. I was talking about what we can all agree on is that we have to believe in five holy books. Now, in order for us to find common ground in these five books, then we can tell where if there's a contradiction, then we know it's a contradiction. But if we find that me, a Christian, a Jew, whatever religion, we have the same, we believe in the same thing. We believe in one God. We believe in Jannah and Jahannam. We believe in so many things. I can continue saying we've over the same prophet. So many. I can just stand here calmly. I can catch my breath and tell you so many common ground. We all believe in day of judgment. We all believe in day of resurrection. Muslims and Christians, they both believe in Raj'at. We're fine. I'm trying to teach you about the previous books that have been given to us.
Okay. The Christians, yeah? They worship, they have the Trinity. But they're not going to
go to the different sects. Just like in Islam, there's 73 versions of different Islam. There's 72 different versions of Christianity. And the real one are not here anymore.
Yeah.
The real one became Muslims when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa sallam came. The Nazareth, there's no more Nazareth people. The actual followers of Isa alayhi salam. And they believed in one God. They did not believe he was the son of God. They didn't, they prayed, they fasted, they done so many things that were the same as us. They used to do Ma'atam, Latmiya, all these sort of things before. The actual followers, in Quran, Allah says followers of Nuh, followers of Musa, followers of Isa, followers of Ibrahim alayhi salam, all of them. So we've been given books that if we start from the beginning, we find certain things that correlate with one another. Every religion believes in a final savior that will come and save
them. If you do not,
I'm choosing to share my information, and with this confrontation.